So yeah, so pratich yuktishas. Then the sutra ahead further says, purvasya trivikramascha, and the preceding varna becomes trivikrama. So this e rama further becomes trivikrama. So pratichas sar rama vishnu sarva vishnu dante pratichaha. So this is we get pratichaha. Okay. Do it for 3-1, please. Make the form for 3-1. Pratyach Yukta Ta. Yeah. Please make and send it on Telegram. Pratyach Yukta Ta. No, not like that, Mataji. Ta is a Bhagavat.
Oh, sorry. Shall I try again?
Yeah.
Yeah, I missed it.
Ta is Bhagavat. Yeah, it's Pratichana. Yes, Ma Prema Mataji, you've done it.
No, sorry, I didn't.
Please do. So it will be, we'll apply the sutra Acho Rama Haro Bhagavati Purvasatra Vikramascha, and it will be Praticha. Okay. Praticha. Then 3.2 Pratyach Yuktvihan. Just 1 minute, please. Pratyach Yukta Bhyam. Now here is a sutra, Sutra 179, which says Purvasya Vishnu Padavatvam Swadi Taddhita Yoraya Sarveshwaradyam. This is quite an interesting sutra. When a Swadi or Taddhita Pratyaya that does not begin with Ya or a Sarveshwara follows, the Prakriti is treated as if it were a Vishnupada. What is a Vishnupada in general? Vishnu Bhakti Siddham Vishnupadam. When we apply Vishnu Bhakti with Prakriti, the Pratyaya with Prakriti, then together they are known as Vishnupada. But here we are imposing, it's a sutra that Prakriti is considered as if a Vishnupada, which means the karyas of Vishnupada will be applied in this case. So Prakriti is considered like Vishnupada. When any Swadhi or Tadhita Pratyaya follows, required that they shouldn't begin with Sarveshwara or Yarama. So, okay, done. So we have Bhyam, where we have Bharama, which doesn't start with Ya or Sarveshwara.
Does this include the indicatory letters when it says does not begin? Because most of the indicatory letters are not that. Or does it mean just the part without the indicatory letters?
Yeah, the part without it.
Thanks.
So Pratyajukta Bhyam, by this sutra, Purvasya Vishnupada Vattam Sadita Dhita Yoraya Sarveshwara Adyoho, Pratyaj is now considered as a Vishnupada. Then we apply that sutra. Vishnu Daso Vishnu Padante Hari Ghoshecha Hari Gada. The very first sutra of Vishnu Dina Sandhi. And by that sutra, wait a minute. Chavargasa. Yeah, actually, Chavargasa Kavarga will be applied. 177.
Oh.
Because Pratyaj is now considered as a Vishnupada and Cha Rama is situated at the end of Vishnupada. So Cha Vargasya Ka Varga Vishnupadante. The Cha Varga changes to Ka Varga when it's at the end of Vishnupada. So Cha becomes Ka. Pratyak Yukta Bhyam. And then Vishnu Dasa Vishnu Dante Hari Ghoshecha Hari Gada. So Pratyag Bhyam, like that.
I think that's 61.
Yeah, 61. Pratyagbhyam. Okay. Now all the rest of the forms, they follow the same pattern. So when Bhagavat follows, we apply this sutra 178, Acho Rama Haro Bhagavati. And when we have any pratyay following which do not have Sarveshwara at the beginning, so we apply Purva Sarveshwara Padavattam, which means Prakriti is considered as Vishnu Pada, and then we apply sutras which are required. So please solve from 3.3 and the whole thing till 7.3. Yeah, please do it. Yeah, please do. Okay, so we'll resume. So Mahaprabhu Mataji, you can send, if you're not done, you can do it and send after class. And yes. So that was the word pratyach. Then there is this word tiryach, which means horizontal, and tiryach is also for the word animal is also known as tiryach in Sanskrit. So tiryach yuktasu, it's the same way like we did pratyach. So and achas chaturbhujanu bandhanam tunam krishna sthane ante sarveshrat paramita sthanam. Then Su is deleted, Radha Vishnu Janabhyam, Ipash Chatri Vikramat Sor Haraha, and then Tavargasya Chavargas Chavarga Yogi, Na becomes Nya, then Satsanganta Sehara Vishnu Dante, the last final Varna of Satsanga is deleted, and then Chavargasya Kavarga Vishnu Padante Vaishnavitva Savarga, the Chavarga becomes Kavarga here, so Nga, Tiryam. Then Triyangchau, Triyangchaha. Okay. Then Triyangcham, Triyangchau. Then when it comes to 2.3. So Tiryach Yuktashas. Here we have a sutra. Tiryachas tirashchir udacha udichir bhagavati. That when a bhagavat follows, the word tiryach is replaced by tirashchi and the word udach by udichi. So now shas is a bhagavat, right? And tiryach will be replaced by this tirashchi where iram is it. So by applying sutra 180, current sutra, tiryach is tirashchir. Shas is a bhagavat, so tiryach is replaced by tirashchi, where iram is it, and shas, where us remains. So it becomes tirashchah, sarrama vishnu sarvavishnu dhanta, tirashchah. Similarly, tirashchah, then 3.2, tiryagbhyam, tiryagbhi, tirashche, tiryagbhyam, tiryagbhyaha. And this is the table. Tiryashtha, Tiryagbhyam, Tiryagbhyaha, Tirashtha, Tirashtho, Tirashcham, Tirashchi, Tirashtho, Tiryakshu, Tiryam, Tiryamcha, Tiryamcha. Same. Nothing different. So Tiryashtha, Tirashtha, and Udacha, Udichi. The word Udach is replaced by the word Udichi. Udichi, this word. So we have this word udach now. So udach yuktasu, udam, same way. Udamchau, udamcham, udamchau, udamchaha. Sorry, till 2.3 it will be udam, udamcha, udamchaha, udamcham, udamchau. And when shas comes, so we apply the sutra again, 180. Udacha udichi. So because Bhagavat is following, so udach is replaced by udichi. So udichaha. Okay, udichaha, and udicha, udagbhyam, udagbhyaha, ityadi. Udichaha, udagbhyam, udagbhyaha, udichaha, udichaha, udicham, udichi, udichaha, udakshu. See, this is also there. This ka, because yadav matre hari kamlam. And then this sa becomes sha. Why? Because Ishvara harimitra ka rama nebhya. Ka rama is also purva nimitta. In that sutra. That's why this sa becomes sha, udakshu. Udang, udangcha, udangcha. Okay. Mahaprema Mataji, is it understandable? Any difficulty?
I'm following Prabhu, yes.
Basically the same pattern. So if you get pratyach right, then the rest of these words will be easy. Similarly, okay, this is different. Little different. Would you try crunch?
Get into the Vishnu Janas, the words are becoming more obscure.
Yeah, you can say like that. I mean, the words, the Prakriti itself, they're quite scary, right? Just to see them.
Well, it's an English word, crunch.
No, not that crunch.
This is crunch. Yeah, I know, but yeah, I don't see Sanskrit.
No, actually it's there. There is one bird whose name is crunch. I don't know what's in English. Let's see. So crunch is a bird. Osprey.
Osprey I've heard of. Curlew I never heard of before either. So
is it a bird?
Osprey, yes.
Yeah, so crunch is the name of a bird, actually. So this is from crunch only. So this crunch, Yukta Su, then Satsangantasya, no, Adavishnu Janabhyam Ipaschatri Vikramat Soraraha, Su is deleted. And then Satsangantasya Aravishnu Vadante, Cha is deleted. And then Cha Vargasya Kavargo, Vishnu Vadante, Vaishnavitva Svarge, it becomes Krung. Krungcha, Krungcha, Krungcham, Krungcha, Krungcha, Krungcha. This Krungcha Yukta Bhyam. So first of all, Purvasya Vishnupada Vattam Swadita Dhityoraya Sarveshra Adhyo is applied, Sutra 179. And by that, it is considered a Vishnupada. Then Satsangata Sahara Vishnupadante is applied and we delete the Cha Rama. And then we apply Chavargasya Kavargo. So it becomes Krungbhyam. And so on. Krungbhi, Krungche, Krungbhyam, Krungbhyaha, Krungchaha, Krungbhyam, Krungbhyaha, Krungchaha, Krungchaha, Krungcham, Krungchi, Krungchaho, Krungshu, Krungshu. Now here if you see, Ishvara Harimitra Karama Nibhya, Nibhya, it says Nibhya, na? The fourth one. So this is Nga. So this is also Purva Nimitta. That's why Sa becomes Sha, Rungshu. And yeah, that's how we get the table. Yeah. Okay. So any questions till here? So we did quite a few sutras today. So we'll resume tomorrow with this part and let's read Anvaya Bhagavatam. So this is Anvaya and I believe we were on chapter 4 or the last part of chapter 3. So Srimad Bhagavatam, canto 1 and chapter is... Yeah, chapter 3. Yeah, we discussed this shloka 37. If you remember, the nutter actor we were discussing about. So we discussed this 37th, now 38th. Chapter 3 and text 38. Saveda dhatu padavim parasya duranta viryasya rathanga pane yo mayaya santatayanu vritya bhaje tatat pada saroja gandham. Anvaya. Yaha yo janah. Amayaya akutila bhavena santataya nirantaraya atyadaraya ityarthah. Anuvritya anukulyena tat pad saroj gandham Bhagavat Pad Padma Saurabham Bhajeta Seveta. Saha Sa Eva Bhaktaha Duranta Viryasya Urukramasya Parasya Dhatu Sarva Shrestha Vidhatu Adi Devasya Vishnoritiva Rathanga Pane Chakrapane Padavim Mahatmyam Veda Kathamchit Janati. So this shloka says, Yaha Janaha, one who worships or serves the fragrance, literally the fragrance of the lotus feet of the Lord. This is a way of saying basically one who serves the lotus feet of the Lord. But here it is said, one who serves the fragrance of the lotus feet of the Lord. It can mean two things. One is one who serves the lotus feet of the Lord, and another meaning could be one who serves the fragrance, in the sense one who inhales, one who takes the fragrance of the lotus feet of the Lord in. For example, the Chatushkumaras, they basically served the fragrance by inhaling it. Of course, that was Tulsi offered to the lotus feet of the Lord, but the same thing. So one who serves the lotus feet of the Lord, how? Amayaya, akutila bhavena, without any duplicity. Kutila means what? Yeah, without any duplicity, with honesty, you know, no fraud, no crookedness in that. And santataya, always, nirantaraya, and with utmost respect, atyadaraya, ati adaraya, and with a positive attitude, anukulena. Such a devotee, saeva bhakta, certainly knows Veda, the glory, the mahatmya of the Lord Vishnu, who bears or carries Sudarshana Chakra in his hands, on his hand. He is Adi Deva. He's superior to Devas, or he's the origin of Devas, we can say like that also. He is Vidhatu, Vidhatri, Vidhata, he's the maintainer. He is Sarvashrestha, superior, supermost, supreme being. He is Parasya, yeah, Parasya means Sarvashrestha. And he is Urukramasya, Duranta Viryasya, which means he performs feats which showcase his utmost valor, we can say, his utmost strength, valor, etc. Ityartha, this is the meaning. Yeah. Okay. We move ahead.
So Rathanga is a synonym of chakra. So the wheel is a part of a chariot.
Rathanga means chakra. Rathanga, the limb of the chariot, literally. So if we actually see, now Rathanga could literally mean a lot of things connected to Ratha. You know, because in a chariot, there are many limbs, like many things. They have that, the flag, the canopy, the wheels, even the horses, the seat and everything. They are all Rathangas. But conventionally, Rathanga means chakra, wheel of the chariot. Similar to what is that? Pankaja, the word pankaja. Panka means mud. So something which is born on mud. Now many things they appear on mud. Insects also, many things. Plant, this and that, different types of plants, and also lotus. But when we say pankaja, conventionally it means lotus only, mostly, like 99.999%. Similarly, Rathanga here. Okay.
Thank you. And what is the role of katanchit here?
Oh, katanchit means katanchit janati, that such devotee, he knows about the Lord, he knows the glories of the Lord, not fully, but
somewhat.
Yeah, somewhat.
Okay.
Katanchit janati. So this katanchit is connected to with mahatmyam. Katanchit mahatmyam janati. He knows some mahatmya, some glories. So, I mean, even Krishna doesn't know full glories of himself, incomplete. That's mentioned in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So, what about the other entities? Then the next one. Atheha dhanya bhagavanta ittham yadvasudevekhila lokanathe kurvanti sarvatmakamatma bhavam na yatra bhuyah parivarta ugraha. This shloka says, atha yataha bhakta eva bhagavat tattvam janati iti arthaha, ataha iti artha iha jagati bhagavantaha sarvagnyah bhavantaha dhanyah kritarthaha kutaha. Yataha ittham purvokta prashnai akhila lokanathe sarveshwara bhagavati vasudeva vishnau sarvatmakam aikantikam atmabhava manovrittim kurvanti. Yataha Bhagavad Leela Rahasya Shravana Utkantita Bhavanti Ata Dhanya Iti Saralata. I think something is there.
There is no yatra at the very end.
Yataha bhava lila rahasya shana yatra yasvinaha bhava yodite sati bhuyaha punarapi ugraha garbhava sadhi dukhrupa parivartit janma marana adi avartaha namavati. Okay. So this verse says, that because only the devotee is bhakta eva, only a devotee, he knows about the bhagavat tattva, the truth about the Lord, the principles about the Lord. Therefore, in this material world, iha jagati, such devotees, they are sarvagya. Okay, let's check. One, I'm just not sure about that. Bhagavanta shabda. Bhagavanta is used for living. The devotees there, in the sense of they know. So, I'm just 1, 3. So. Yeah, actually, Bhagavanta here means the factly cognizant. So it has got nothing to do with Ishwaratva. So such devotees, they are Bhagavanta. They are Bhagwan in the sense that they are perfectly cognizant because they know about the Bhagavat Tattva. And one who knows about Bhagavat Tattva is perfectly cognizant according to the scriptures. So they are sarvagyas, Because they know Bhagavatattva, and because they know about the Lord, they are Sarvagya, that's why they are Dhanya. They are blessed. Dhanya means they are blessed. Dhanya. They are fortunate. Kritartha. Then, Kritartha Kutaha. Then the question may be, how come they are Kritartha? How come they are fortunate? How come they are blessed? Then, Yataha. Because, Ittham Purvokta Prashnaihi. Akhila Loka Nathe Bhagavati Sarvatmakam Atmabhavam Kurvanti. Because by asking questions like asked here previously, like the six famous questions asked by the rishis and to Suta Goswami. So by such questions, Purvokta Prashnai, such devotees, they engage the inclination and the proclivity of their mind, manovritti. Basically, they engage their mind completely, aikantikam, wholeheartedly or solely in the Lord, in Vasudeva, in Vishnu, who is Akhila Lokanatha, who is the master of all the planetary systems. So that's why they are dhanya. That's why they are fortunate, because they engage their mind in the Lord by inquiring about Him. Yataha Bhagavat Leela Rahasya Shravana Utkantitaha Bhavanti. Because such people, such devotees are excited, eager to hear the confidential pastimes of the Lord. Bhagavat Leela Rahasya Shravana Utkantitaha. Therefore, they are fortunate. Why? They are fortunate because they are eager to hear about the Lord and His intricate pastimes. That's why they are dhanya, fortunate. Iti sarala artha. This is the simple meaning. Yatra yasmin bhagavat bhave udite sati. So one in whom emotions towards the Lord have arisen. I always get confused with this word, arised and its past forms. So whatever it is.
Arisen.
So in one in whom the emotions toward the Lord have arisen, for such a person, bhuya, again, there is no cycle of birth and death in the form of garbhavas, living in the womb of a mother, and so on. They don't have to go through all the cycles again and again. Just by developing those emotions, Bhagavad Bhava, towards the Lord, towards Bhagavan. Iti artha, this is the meaning. Okay.
So in, where was it? Mm-hmm. Sarveshwara. No, that wasn't it.
So that was the anvaya for the shloka. Okay, we'll do.
Sorry, I had a question, but I can't remember it now.
Uh-huh.
Oh, avarta. That's at the very end.
Yeah, avarta is it's like a repetition or the cycle.
Oh, okay.
Avarta. Yeah, revolving, turning round, whirlpool. Trinavarta actually, you know, Trinavarta also, Avarta. The name Trinavarta. Like that. So we'll resume tomorrow ahead. So yeah, we'll stop here for today. Okay. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.